I'm Wyatt.
I'm Tim.
Today we're taking one of our mini 1500 Moorookas. We're going to be putting a personnel carrier on it. We're going to be welding, cutting, grinding. It's going to be a mess today.
We're constantly modifying these Moorookas. Today we have a 1500 Morooka in here that we're going to take from a dump bed into an 18-man personnel carrier.
So to start the installation process, we got to get these lift cylinders pulled out of the way, which are originally used for our dump beds, but now we're going to replace them with these mounting blocks for our personnel carrier.
We're taking the cotter pins out of bed cylinder pins, disconnect both these hydraulic lines, and we can pull them off as one whole assembly.
This is a drink for every technician, mechanic out there, a little bang juice.
We're going to disconnect the hydraulic lines from the dumper valve to the bed cylinders.
That's the best thing about these personnel carriers. Once you put them on, you can take them out there and test the heaters, take your little cat nap. Fantastic. There you go. Good way winner.
Finally got the pump off. Took a minute.
Next step is to take these bed cylinders off.
On here and choke them up and lift them out with a forklift.
Now we have to prep the air so that when we go to mount the personnel carrier, we can weld on the brackets.
We're going to add a jumper wire to our backup alarm power cord. We had to cut it in order to get this channel off so that when we add the brackets to mount the personnel carrier, we're good to go.
We have our personnel carrier all rigged up now. Time to lift it up and set our 1500 Morooka.
Now what we're going to do is we're going to pull it back in the shop. Wyatt's going to get the brackets mounted onto the frame. I'm going to go ahead and get it plumbed up for the heater and all the electrical.
So we got our mounts prepped up, ready to go. Got the paint ground off of them. Now we should climb under the personnel carrier and get them stuck in, bolted on, and weld them down. We're going to take this forklift and raise the personnel carrier up so Wyatt can line the bolt holes up for the brackets so we can set it back down on the frame.
You never know how long it takes, so it's tight. Give her a couple of ugly dubs and you're good to go.
So usually when I load these on, I just give a good heavy root pass and then put two cat passes on it, give it vertical up on both sides, and then I'll put two stringer passes on the sides. Vision isn't really the best, kind of gets a little hard sometimes, but make do with what you got.
So I'm out of the box right now. It's basically a junction box. I'm gonna go to the battery box and run a key hot in the battery box to the end of the day up in here to where we can get power from the machine to the personnel carrier. Bolts are tight, mounting blocks are welded on, wires are ran, heater control valves all ran. This thing's ready for rent.
For all your crawler carrier needs, visit us at NewmanTractor.com.